But you know the devil started out as an angel, talking loud, busy walking around with a halo. You can pull up to the pearly gates with the Range Rover. That's up, but make a reservation for a table.
Ego, that's the root of all evil. Either I could ball or I could hire more people. They say you gon' fall, it's in my fault. Not every man is born equal.
That's perfect, yeah.
Man, fuck a lazy promoter. You should be checking for culture vultures and shady personas. You should be saying, y'all the reason they pay me a bonus. Instead they saying, can y'all go ahead and take me a photo? What's the game plan? I'm a made man. If you ain't fam, don't go reaching for the bottle with your lame ass. It's a train smash, but I don't wanna act like I'm from the Cape Flats. So bounce ASAP. You ain't telling lies, you be telling double stories. Dollar signs, got my whole design dripping saucy. Been a long time since I bought a kick in sports. Sunday morning, it's a vibe with some being boys.
Let's go.
6x9
for the brain news.
Slide a bike for the homies. It's a vibe.
It's a vibe
for the child. Fire flame emoji.
Don't you know the devil started out as an angel, talking loud, busy walking around with a halo. You can pull up to the pearly gates with the Range Rover. That's up, but make a reservation for a table.
Ego, that's the root of all evil. Either I could ball or I could hire more people. They say you gon' fall, it's in my fault. Not every man is born equal.
That's perfect, yeah.
What's up, man? What's up, man? What's up, Sam?
Chasers, welcome to Fat Dreams, and this is a very special episode because this is one in which we're going to give you insight into the fitness life, firstly, and secondly into the mental mind frame of one of the most, I believe, influential personalities in South Africa, Thapelo Mokoena. What's up, bro?
I'm all right, brother. You good?
Good. I'm good.
Yeah. Fat dreams, right?
Fat dreams. Thapelo, I'm going to get straight into it. This morning, we went through the paces. You took me into what you go through. I want to know why you train. And
it's a good question.
More specifically, is there a direct link to the reasons in which you train and your ability thereof to chase and pursue all your other dreams in your life outside of your physical fitness?
I think we all have different reasons why we hit the gym or why we test the body. You know, for me, it's simply realizing that we live in a world where, you know, shortcuts make millionaires. Because that's what it is. You buy convenience. Shortcuts make millionaires. So everything is about, you know, take a pill for this. You're fat, take a pill for that. Are you feeling stressed? Go inject something. Are you sad? Go drink something. Whereas the human body is designed to deal with all of what I've just mentioned naturally. There's a way. Right, the human body is actually quite incredible because it can literally do and achieve anything it wants to. But it begins with the mindset. You know, you first have to, in my world, you first have to get the mind right. So the mind understands what the mission is and then go get it. So gym and fitness for me is like part of what I've already decided in my mind, because I have to make sure that I'm physically ready, physically fit to manage whatever I need to manage. And what I find is with training, it also releases something within you. They call it endorphins, the good energy, the good feel. You know, just 5 minutes of cardio has the ability to wake you up, to straighten your posture, to get you ready to do something. So it's ignition for me. It's a key in the ignition, and it's a boom, boom, boom. Right? It's that. And when I stop training, I can also feel the difference. Because in Jinamikara, without that, there's no warm-up, I'm just straight into the drive. So it's that. It's a kickstart to any day, it's a kickstart to any plan, it's a kickstart to any vision. It begins in the fitness chamber for me. And I appreciate it because I love what it does for me. I love how I feel. I love how I can straighten my thinking. You know, it's a form of meditation, it's medicine for me. And is there a direct link to my fitness and my everyday life? Absolutely. I'm an actor. I'm a performer. I don't always have to be ripped and ready. But it's good to know that my base camp or my base is fitness. If the role needs me to be obese, I'll take it from there. But I'm already disciplined in terms of muscle memory. You know, if I need to be skinny, lose it all, I can go there.
You have options.
But my base camp is always this. Lean, agile, flexible, and coverless. You know, that's my base camp. So there is a link. And also, I'm a father. I must be able to play with my son, who runs literally the entire day. Kids are fit. That's all they do. They don't stop. So for me to engage him, to play with him, interact with him, father him, I need to undo what tradition did, which is not be the father who said in the Rembrandt Mozala. Yeah, humble and remote, you know what I'm saying? Mkhaba is no longer the definition of an African man. It was never, in fact. We're fit. We ran and walked.
Yeah.
We had land, so we could. We're naturally, we're born this way. So fit is actually something I've gone and repossessed. Because at some point I had forgotten about the importance of staying fit.
So you're saying that in essence you're trying to redefine what fitness should mean to our society and how it should wage itself in daily life, you know, in application, practical application.
I'm showing you how much 24 hours or how much time, how valuable time is. And if you invest your time the best way you can, it shows you things.
So
it right. Rewards me as well. At the end of my day, I'm rewarded.
And I think with fitness, as it is in the commercial sense of it, it's been trivialized and diluted, you know, into six-packs, magazine shoots, cover shoots, you know what I mean? And it's really not about that.
Yeah, it's not.
Because I'm from, and I'm still undergoing my own personal fitness transformation, you know?
Yeah.
And I found that more than my physical manifestation,
yeah,
it's what it's teaching me in the process, you know? It's the principles and the values.
The discipline.
That are being instilled and inculcated into my mind on a daily, every morning when I do that exercise, and it's tough, you know?
Yeah,
and
overcoming.
It's those, and you touched on one, discipline, but I want to know, what are the principles and those values that in your space, in your life, that fitness teaches you on a daily, you know? You've already touched on one. First, discipline. Second, respect time, you know? Those kind of things that people may not understand that have a thread tied into fitness. What other values and principles does fitness teach?
You know, it's like karate to an extent. You know, you learn how to kick kata 1, kata 5, kata 8 for a year, 2 years, and then they tell you don't beat anyone up, don't
never use
people. It. Yeah, never use it. Don't you know? Don't be that guy. And I find that it's such a long-winded way of teaching you discipline, teaching you how to think, teaching you decision making. The same way fitness, I think, is in the same space, like teamwork. you walk into the gym, it's not just about you. You gotta greet the lady at the gym, set your stuff up, or the treadmills are busy, you gotta wait your turn. Who's next? I'm only allowed 20 minutes. Move, let the next person go. So you're already thinking not for yourself, but for the gym life. Sorry, bro, are you done with those 20s? Yes, one more set. Okay, I'll wait. While I'm waiting, pull this one. So it's a...
manners, courtesy.
Courtesy, manners, gym etiquette.
Etiquette.
You know, it's a process that does so much more for you. Because you all together in this room, this chamber, to come get one thing. Progress. You've come there to... you pay a month so you can dig out bits and pieces of progress every day, whenever you go in. So, hell yeah. You know, you could be sitting at home on the couch with no responsibility, but walking into gym already gives you a sense of responsibility. Don't throw it on the floor. Pick up your towel. Lock up your stuff. You know, what you wanna eat next. You're constantly thinking, your brain is doing this. You know, so I value that about the process of gym and fitness. I also like the idea of people in the same room for a common goal. It's unity, right? It's togetherness, it's inspiration. Keep going, bud, I don't even know you. Shit, that was a hectic workout. How'd you do that? Teach me. Sorry, bro, can you spot me? You know what I'm saying? It's a beautiful thing.
The metaphors that are carried that you can then apply to the bigger scheme of things. For instance, if your goal is economic emancipation, those things apply.
It's life.
It's life, eh?
It's like, you know, it's applied thinking. You don't go to school to learn math so you can learn how to times 4 by 4. You learn so you can learn how to solve problems. The bigger picture. So fitness is that, bro. And align that to chasing dreams, align that to chasing goals. Trust me, if you fit mentally, physically, you're the fittest in the room already. You're almost a step ahead. You know, if you feel good, if your muscles are sore, but you know why they're sore. It's a good feeling. If your shirt is on you and it sits on you, you're a step ahead. You're not worried about that. If your walk is upright, then that's you. If you speak in the crowd and you go, hello, and they say, what? You know, job done. The rest is still a good idea. Pitch something. Win. If you go to an audition, you're ready, bro. Like, doesn't matter. You're ready. You're ready because your physique says yo. And especially as a man, the older you get, the more important it is to be well. Prostate cancer, you name them. There's so many sugar diabetes. These are common diseases in our society. What you put in now is what you get out in 10, 20 years. If I put this in now, I'll be a flipping sexy ass, happy ass 50-year-old man.
50, 60-year-old.
You know what I'm saying?
Ukulupe.
Ukulupe. My kids, you know, share in the shallow world, they'll call it Ukulupe, but I'll be a happy man. Happiness.
Happier than the next guy.
The joy is happiness, yeah. No back pains. If I pick something up, I'm like, No, I'm out here. I'm back up. You know, I'm a happy man.
I think what I'm getting from you now is, for me, nothing short of amazing. Because
thank you.
This is the reason why I wanted to have people like yourself to come on the platform to speak about this, you know? Because I think, in a short sense, people have stopped dreaming, you know, in the world. And dreams are free, but people have stopped dreaming because people are now diluted in a sense that they feel if they don't want more, they can't be disappointed. Or they won't be ridiculed that, where do you think it's going to end up?
It's far-fetched.
That fear of failure, you know what I mean? And I think then, by virtue of that, they live vicariously through other people like yourselves. People they see on TV, people they see on social media that they think live perfect lives, you know? And another person will see Tapelo and say, Tapelo, what does Tapelo have to worry about? Good looking, he won the genetic lottery.
Genetic lottery, yeah.
He's famous. Tupel is rich.
I wish.
You know? And they'll say, you were meant for this life, you know? And I want people to hear firsthand from you.
I'm just a boy like you.
Yeah. And what it is that you need to do on a daily to actually earn those accolades, to earn your space in whatever you choose to do, you know?
Yeah.
You're a creator, you're an entrepreneur. You're, in my opinion, one of the forefront, the leaders of the African Renaissance. You know, you're a father, you're a husband. And those are all different roles and different hats you have to wear.
And it's hard to walk in the park.
And all of them require different skill sets.
Just like you went and achieved your goal, and you're still achieving it because you were a big boy. And here you are, lean, ripped, you know what I'm saying? Just like you went and got that done. Why can't the next person? Two kinds of people in the world is leaders and followers. Nothing wrong with either. If you're a leader, acknowledge it, be responsible, and make sure you empower followers to be the best. And if you're a follower, you best be the best damn follower there is. Be number one in whatever you do. If you're following, be the number one follower. If you're a winner, be the number one leader and win. You know what I'm saying? We can't all lead, and we can't all follow, but I'll be damned if I'm number two follower. You know what I'm saying? So nothing wrong, Ghana, like, this is life, you know, and purpose. You must know what you're good at and do what you're good at, and let those who are good at what they do do it. The camera's rolling because the guy is good at rolling cameras. That's what he does. Let him do it. I can't be rolling a camera and talking to you. So I've acknowledged what my powers are. I know what I'm good at. I'm growing up. I'm 35. I've pinpointed what it is that makes me unique, special. I know what my special ingredient is. I know what my signature thing is. I know what my DNA artist or DNA of man or human that I am, or person that I am. I get myself. And that, I think, is the beginning. And fitness has had a lot to do with that. I've always been a sporty guy. I always was a champion. My mom's a high jump champion. I was always 100 meter champion, high jump champion, long jump champion. It's all I was. Then I moved to the Joburg side of things, the city. I slacked because I was trying to grow. I was finding other things. I was in relationships, girls, living the life. I'm on TV. Now I'm winning. My career's on the up. Then I forgot about that fitness life or that what made me. When I took that back, it all just went.
Fell into place.
And then everything falls into place. Money, family. It just all happens. You know, now I'm shooting campaigns. Now I'm shooting brands. Now I'm signing big brands. Now
you
I'm
attracted this.
Yeah,
it was a pull.
All I did was I was good to myself, and the rest fell into place. That's all that's all it was. I took care of myself. You know, I'm saying I'm not perfect, but I made sure that I was ready. And the powers that be see that I'm ready, so they're knocking. You know what I'm saying? That's all you gotta do. Show up. Go to gym and see what happens. Get fitter and see what happens. Eat right and see what happens. Don't be perfect, because nobody is. But practice makes permanent, doesn't make perfect. The more you practice, Lionel Messi, Leonardo, DiCaprio, Denzel, they're as good as they are because they practice more often.
Repetition.
Practice makes permanent. It does not make perfect. The more I act, the better I get. The more you gym, the better you get. The more you shoot, better you get.
No one is born with it.
Nah.
It's the hard work.
You're born with the potential.
Yeah.
To realize it is something else. And I think as Africans, we deprived of execution. Bafana Bafana, we've got a great team. We can't execute. Springbok, we don't execute. Careers, actors. You act for 20 years, but you die broke. We don't execute. Financial fluency. We don't execute. I want a gym. New Year's resolution. We don't execute.
Commit.
Got it.
We have so many platforms that we can speak and communicate and actually liberate ourselves in terms of speech. But I find with those platforms comes prisons, because they are image-based and
impression based,
and there's sponsors, there's money, there's so many things involved, so there's things you cannot say. But for the sake of being real, what are the personality traits, you know, that you know and around the people close to you that you have always been aware of, that training helped you either suppress or manage or completely get rid of, you know? How did training sort you out as a person? Because no one is perfect from an interpersonal point of view.
Like I said in my first question, gives me balance. It's a good base. That's what it did. It gave me a good base. You know, training gave me a good base, a good place to start from. The rest is... knowing who you are in every setting is all you need. Nothing else influences my energy. Nothing else disturbs my energy. Because I've decided what my energy is for the day, and whatever you do around that, I just stick to
that. That surety of self, was it always there, or has it been enhanced by it?
No. It's always been there, but it's just now more solid and more grounded and more, it's a more confident ground.
And in closing, to that high school kid who is trying to find themselves. They have a dream, but it's not supported by their surroundings, but it lives inside of them, and then they're trying to make sense of it. To that young adult who's also trying to carve out themselves in this world, you know, that is being polluted and drowned by so many different influences, but they have this dream that they can't even explain to anyone else.
Sure.
To that 30-year-old individual who thinks that they are defined by the mistakes they've made in life, you know, that now they only have to lie in the bed they've made, irrespective of the dreams they have. To that middle-aged person who thinks they are over the hill and they're just waiting for retirement or the grave, where do they start to kickstart these dreams? How do they start?
I don't know how they start. I don't know if fitness can balance them better than they are. It's everyone's personal journey. I don't know how they start. I don't know. Sometimes the hardest thing is to start something for people. It's intimidating. What are they going to say? What are they going to think? Will I fail? I don't know where you should start. But I know that fitness can help ground you, balance you, even out your energy. You know, be okay with the feeling of you. And maybe that's a good place to start. We have to be more physical. South Africans are not healthy. We don't want to end up like in America. We consume too much sugar. It's too processed. We're born in Africa. The ground is fertile. It's rich. We're born in rural areas. We're not city kids. Nobody's from the city. So ask yourself where we come from and why we were stronger then than now. Why do Nigerians look and feel the way they do? Why are Kenyans as sharp and strong as they are? What is it that we consume? What are we investing in our bodies that determines our outcomes? Why have we got sugar diabetes problems? Why is our every second grandfather or uncle suffering from a prostate? These are the questions. The soil and nature has all the answers. Africa is prime. Its nature is godly. What you do about that is on you. And that's it, my man. Thank you so much.
My brother. Bless.
Thank you, man. All the best with the journey.
Thank you.
Fat Dreams.
Thank you for being on. Thank you for inspiring everyone.
Yeah.
I think everyone who's watching will source and will extract exactly what I do.
Yeah,
and spur us on all our journeys. Fat Dreams.
That's the hope. Back to making TV. Peace out. Big up.
Man and brain.